Okay, good afternoon, everybody, and I would like first to thank organizers for inviting me to such interesting conference. And I will discuss a new type of lasing, which could appear in case of when we want to achieve lasing with strongly interacting bosons. And this would be a system which is not out of equilibrium, when we have a pump and dissipation of bosons, driven dissipative system. And I will discuss a situation when we are very close to the condensation or lasing threshold, when the pump and dissipation are very close to each other. In fact, we are going to from below to the average condensation threshold. And the concrete system I will be interested in would be exciton polaritons and semiconductor microcavities. And that system was already introduced several times during this conference, in particular by Alexei Kavokin and by Natasha Berlov. But I still will say some words, and I will try to avoid. This system in general is complex because we have a system out of equilibrium, we have excitons, we have relaxation of excitons, we have formation of polaritons. So description of this system, for example, in means of generalized Gross-Pitayevsky equation and Boltzmann equation for the excitons involves a lot of numerical calculations. And we do need this numerical calculation if we want to describe real system. However, I will try to make a point. I will try to describe specific qualitative effects. So I will consider very model system when this effect appears. And this effect is called weak lasing, and it is characterized by formation of states which are substantially many particle states. They are different from single particle states. And then I will discuss the recent observation of this effect in case of polarization degree of freedom of trapped condensate and in case of polariton superlattices. So exciton polaritons are combined quasi-particles which are mixed excitons and photonic mode. Semiconductor microcavity consists of two distributed Bragg mirrors, so I have two different semiconductors, this gray and black, which are different semiconductors, say gallium arsenide, aluminum gallium arsenide, and the thickness of this layer is, say, lambda over 2, so those are, in fact, mirrors, distributed Bragg mirrors. And then there is a defect, which is, for example, several wave lenses, and it is possible to put quantum wells inside, and this they put quantum wells exactly in antinodes of there is some cavity mode for photonic cavity mode which oscillates here, there is some oscillation here, and then it's decaying opposite, and you put they put quantum wells exactly in antinodes a maximum of electric field of this cavity mode to achieve the strong coupling between this mode and excitons. So if I plot, if I forget about coupling and just plot exciton level, that would be in this scale just straight line. Exciton does have effective mass, but this mass is very large. So this is parabola or something like that. And microcavity mode is also parabola with respect to wave vectors and planes in horizontal direction. It's also parabola, but this parabola is characterized by very small effective mass, which is like 10 to the minus 4, 10 to the minus 4, 5 of free electron mass. Now, if I turn the interaction between excitons and microcavity modes on, then I would have Ribe splitting, because I would have the formation of two new quasi-particles, which is shown by blue here and called exciton polaritons, and this splitting would be Rabi frequency. Usually, this Rabi frequency is achieved about tens of milliEV, like 10, 20 milliEV. And this exciton shines light, so in fact, this photon in this microcavity mode could escape, and this is visible light. So there is no spontaneous creation of excitons. To make the system useful, we have to pump it. And when you pump some excitons, and then you have formation of polaritons. These polaritons are mixed quasi-particles due to due to contribution of light, they have very small effective mass, and this effective mass is good because if you consider the system as equilibrium one, you could suggest that, for example, if you get condensation of these particles corresponding Austerlitz Tauliz, temperature would be high. Indeed, you could reach in fact condensation at like in room temperature. However, this system is out of equilibrium, and these particles, these polaritons could relax because due to contribution of excitons, they interact with each other, interact with phonons. Still, there is some limitation in this relaxation. In particular, there is bottleneck region when velocity of polariton exceeds the sound velocity. The sound velocity in the crystal, they no longer can emit acoustical phonons. There is some accumulation of particles here. And then due to interaction, there is still some flux at the bottom of this dispersion. And one can speculate about condensation. Now, the word exciton polariton condensation and exciton polariton lasing are used interchangeably. And it depends mostly on how people want to sell their work. I will consider this system as lasing. So it is important that this effect was experimentally achieved. And one of the way to overcome this limitation of which imposed by energy momentum conservation is consider a dirty system. Consider the system with some disorder, substantial disorder. In particular, the first observation of this exciton polariton condensation was observed in cadmium tellur-based samples when disorder, strain disorder is strong. Also, you can also put some super lattice on top of the structure and consider patterned structures. So it is natural here to consider the system with disorder, and let's consider the case when you have several condensation state localized, for example. And what is important for me will be that actually you have already interest in physics if you just consider two states. And now it is also natural to assume that if you have different states in the system, in disordered systems, then different states would possess different lifetimes. Lifetimes with respect to escape from this microcavity. So what happens in this case if you have strongly interacting bosons in this system when you have different states with different lifetimes? What happens in this case? And I will start with very, very simple equation. So I consider two states, and that would be the amplitude of condensate in each state. It's a complex number. And this complex number is subject of these two nonlinear equations. So first, I have this governing parameter, G, which is the difference of decay rate, escape rate, which is inverse lifetime of particles, say average lifetime of particle in state one, which is supposed to be the same in one and two. And this W would be the pump rate. And then there is interaction of particles inside of each center, which alpha is the interaction constant. And then there would be coupling between one and two. And this coupling, there are two couplings. One is usual Josephson coherent coupling. And then I would assume that there is also some dissipative coupling. And this dissipative coupling is very important for the effects I'm going to discuss. Now, the same system you could discuss in terms of symmetric and anti, so it should be A here as a subindice. So in terms of symmetric and anti-symmetric states. And in this basis, you immediately obtain that you have decoupled symmetric and anti-symmetric state in linear approximation. And then you have coupling between these states, and this coupling appears due to interaction between particles. You can see here that the energies of symmetric and anti-symmetric states are different. Symmetric states get smaller energy, is minus J over 2. The energy of anti-symmetric states is higher, is plus J over 2. And they also have different lifetimes. The lifetime of symmetric states is short, so dissipation rate is strong, is big gamma plus small gamma. On the other hand, the lifetime of antisymmetric states is long, and or dissipation rate is weak. So in fact, we have some distribution of lifetimes. So in place of having one single threshold, we have some sort of threshold region of the width 2 gamma small. Okay, so this is what are here in these equations. What are not here? What is not here is usual dissipative nonlinearity you usually need for lasers. For example, forget about psi 2, consider just psi 1. Then this equation would be bad. For example, if gamma is positive when you just below the threshold, then your psi would be zero. The system cannot sustain particles, the pump is very small, and the escape of particles is very strong. However, if you cross the threshold and go to the region of negative gamma, then the system would just explode, the psi would go to infinity. And usually when you make a laser theory, you add some dissipative nonlinearity here. So in place, I don't want to consider for the moment this dissipative nonlinearity. I would assume that it dissipative nonlinearity is smaller than nonlinearity coherent due to interaction of particles. It turns out that interaction of particle alone can stabilize the system. So there are different reasons why we can have different states with different lifetime. One reason is dissipative coupling already discussed by Natasha Berlov. Consider, for example, now two condensation centers. And now I want to discuss the emission of light from these centers. Now, if I consider symmetric states, then it would mean that the phase difference between the centers is zero. It means that there is constructive interference of waves emitted by different centers, and that this constructive interference would increase the escape of particles. On the other hand, if I assume that the phase difference is pi, which corresponds to antisymmetric states, in these states, these waves emitted by different centers would cancel each other. There would be destructive interference. And that is reflected by the fact that, in fact, we have antisymmetric states would have a longer lifetime than polariton in antisymmetric state would live longer in the cavity than the polariton put in the symmetric state. The very fact that we have this sort of dissipative coupling between two polariton condensates is not specifically quantum or polariton effect. We do know this from classical physics, and well-known examples, two Huygens clock, which are two oscillators, which could communicate to each other because they are connected to the same beam. For example, when we have oscillation of one, it could emit sound waves, and the other could emit sound waves. Now if they oscillate out of phase with pi phase difference, the waves emitted by different oscillators destructively interfere and cancel each other, so the dissipation of the system is reduced, and that's why the known effect exists that two oscillators synchronize out of phase. And of course, we can also put some string here and have normal Josephson coupling between them. Now, what happens in this system if I just go above the first threshold? And if my pump, this G, defined by G, I would still consider G positive parameter, so I would be below the average threshold in the system, so gamma dissipation would be bigger than W. However, I would assume that this gamma is smaller than gamma small. In this case, I am above, so if I just consider antisymmetric states, for this particular states, I will be above the threshold. And it would mean that, for example, if I put system in this state, the system would explode. The number of particles would grow exponentially with time, and the system would go to infinity. Indeed, such solution exists. However, this is the only trajectory that goes to infinity. If I, for example, violate this phase difference, move it away from pi, or I, for example, put different number of particles, different number of particles in different centers, the trajectory would be close, so I would have some dynamics of dynamics with some finite occupation of particles. And in fact, in this system, you should understand that there is some noise always, some noise term. So existence of this divergent trajectory doesn't matter. If you include noise, you immediately would go away from this trajectory. Where you go? It turns out that in place of finding these anti-symmetric states, you would obtain two different states, which we call weak lasing state. So in fact, it is good to consider the system as just nonlinear dynamical system. And what we are interested in nonlinear dynamical system, we would study its phase portrait. We need to look for attractors. And first things to do is just try to find the fixed point. And fixed point, we just consider the solutions when this left-hand side is zero. And it turns out that there are two solutions, which we called weak lasing solution. They correspond to some non-trivial occupations of both centers. And it also corresponds that one center has smaller occupations than the other. And this number of occupations is given by these expressions. And this phase difference between two centers is also non-trivial. It is not exactly pi. It is different from pi. Phase difference is 2 phi, and it is somewhere between pi and pi over 2. So here we have spontaneous symmetry breaking. Each attractor provides spontaneous symmetry breaking. So this system of equation is symmetric with respect to interchange of indices 1 and 2. However, the solutions are not. So let me illustrate what happens in this system if you just study to increase pumping below the... So this parameter G would correspond to the pumping. Increase of pumping would correspond when I go down in this figure. So first, in fact, what we find that this solutions I just showed in this previous transparency, they are unstable. In fact, what the system forms, they form limit circle, and I will tell something about it, but then this limit circle transforms to this symmetry breaking solution. So characteristic of symmetry breaking solution is we have breaking of disparity symmetry. One center obtains highly populated, the population in the other is small, the phase difference is non-trivial, which means that there is some flux of particles from 1 to 2 in this case. And we have those several symmetries broken in weak lasing state. In particular, there is parity symmetry broken, and there is time reversal symmetry broken. So for example, if I consider the spectrum of light emitted from the system, it doesn't have the symmetry k to minus k. So this is what happens if I just go from up to down. So first, I have this plenty of more or less chaotic emission, then emission which consists a lot of peaks. And distance between peaks is 2 hour period, because my system here corresponds to fixed attractor corresponds to limit circle. The system rotates with some period, which depends on the parameters of the system. Then period decreases. The distance between peaks increases, and finally we reach the situation when there is one peak which corresponds to weak lasing regime. Now, in fact, there is some interesting physics happening here. So, in fact, there is period doubling bifurcations. So if I change the parameter, there is a period doubling bifurcation. The system goes to limit circle, and then it doesn't close, and the period doubles. And then in fact, when I go to this region, there is some chaotic behavior. This period doubling bifurcation are illustrated here in this figure. For example, this is emission of this. So this state, when system exhibits this this limit circle behavior corresponds to emission of so-called frequency comb. This frequency comb is very, very, very useful technically because in atomic system are used for atomic clocks. And here, for example, we can achieve the regime when distance between peaks corresponds to terahertz region. But what is also interesting is how the system evolves. For example, if I decrease the pumping, there is this period doubling bifurcation, and finally there is Feigenbaum root to chaos. Also, even in this regime, when there is a limit circle solution, we can appreciate asymmetry, because here on these figures we have emission spectra from centrum 1, and here from centrum 2 we can appreciate that they are different, qualitatively different, so which corresponds to this broken symmetry between spontaneously broken symmetry between 1 and 2. So this is the effect. In a real system, of course, it is necessary to take into account what I mentioned as lasing non-linearity, dissipative non-linearity, which could be done by changing this parameter G, which is difference between dissipation and pump. We need to add non-linearity, which is proportional to the occupation of the system. And this parameter eta should be compared to the interaction of particles parameter alpha. It is usually smaller than alpha. And in this case, it changes slightly the dynamics of the system. So if we increase pumping, the system first is, the condensate first is formed in antisymmetric state or pi state, and that would be just simple condensation in this antisymmetric states. And at some pumping, this state loses stability, and there is formation of one of two weak lasing state. And this bifurcation reminds second order Fourier transition when, if you consider the order parameter as occupation difference between, well, this corresponding phase, some complex number, say, difference of wave functions psi 1 and minus psi 2. Okay, so now the same effect you can observe if you, in place of considering two different centers, you just consider one single condensate but consider polarization of polaritons. So those polaritons could be characterized by polarization, right circular or left circular, and we can write the same equation, for example, if we consider one as the right circular polarization and two as left circular polarization, we would have slightly different equation because interactions that the terms would be slightly different because there is usually strong repulsion of particles with the same polarization. So for this parameter alpha 1 would be some positive parameter. And there is some small attraction of polaritons with opposite circular polarization. So this parameter alpha 2 is about 10% by the magnitude of alpha 1, but it is negative. So in this case, if you consider polarization case, the meaning of parameters gamma and J, it's something different. For example, J, in fact, would define the splitting between X and Y linearly polarized condensates. And this is this is known effect, first predicted and discussed by Igor Elener and Evgeny Ivchenko in 92. It appears because the symmetry in quantum well is usually low, is usually C to V, so we don't have a rotation of 90 degree, and that's why X and Y should be different. Also, in real systems, there are always some strains, strain fields, and they also lower the symmetry. So it is not unusual to have splitting between X and Y polarized light in microcavity, this dichroism. And also, if we have splitting between X and Y, we also, in general, should assume that they possess different lifetimes. We should remember that this photon states reside inside the stop band of distributed Bragg mirrors. So if I have two states in stop band, inside the stop band, the state which is close to the edge would have shorter lifetimes. So in general, here we have also should have different lifetime of X and Y polarized state. Also, I will need this picture. It is known when in place of using two complex number, we just make the matrix element of components of Pauli matrices, and we obtain three real numbers, and there is also total phase. So this is usually called as Stokes or Poincaré sphere, and formation of, for example, pi condensate would correspond to negative value of S6. So this is where I'm pointing now. That would be formation of condensate in antisymmetric states. Formation of weak Lasin state would correspond to the effect when occupation of one, for example, is bigger than the occupation of two or vice versa. And it would correspond to formation of condensate at some points in the north semisphere or south semisphere. Now, this is the equation in terms, the same equation, but now written in terms of this pseudo-spin vector, Sx and Sy as z. This is the solutions. There are two weak Lasin solutions. One corresponds to positive value of Sz. Sz now is the difference between occupation of left circularly, right circularly polarized and left circularly polarized. And there are some specific features of this state. For example, if I consider these components of this spin could be measured experimentally. In fact, what experimentalists do, they measure difference between horizontal and vertical. So they observe life horizontally polarized and vertically polarized. And difference between this intensity would relative difference between these two intensities would give me Sx. If I want to calculate Sy, I just measure diagonal and anti-diagonal. And finally, Sz would correspond to measuring of intensity of right circularly and left circularly polarized light. Now we can see here that vertical component is always bigger than horizontal. So Sx is always negative. However, for example, if I have in weak Lasin state, if I have formation in north semisphere, I would have anti-diagonal, strong anti-diagonal component. Information this should be different indices. Formation of condensate in the south semisphere would correspond to formation of strong diagonal components. Now, experiment of this type was done recently in the Jeremy Baumberg group and in Cambridge. So to observe this effect, it is important, it turns out to be important, to consider so-called trapped condensate, condensate which are separated from reservoirs. This interaction, because interaction within the condensate, reservoirs contain, in this case, what they do, they create four reservoirs, these four points. And then these excitons could transform into polaritons in form the condensate this here in the center. So this condensate doesn't communicate with reservoirs, and this is important for the observation of the effect. Also, what they do, this is in fact microcavity membrane, which is about 300 micrometers in diameter. And in fact, we can not only non-resonantly excite the condensate, we can also talk to it and excite by some pulses. And indeed, what they observe formation randomly of two weak Lasin states with either left or right circular component. The formation of this state is random, so if we turn off the laser, and then we turn it on again, the pump, then we randomly generate condensate as it is seen here. There is some trains of pulse, excitation pulses, and we have random either left or light formation of either left or light or right condensates. Also, it is possible to reproduce limit circle solution and everything. How much time do I have? Thank you very much. So this is first experiment which demonstrated the formation of weak lasing state and related spontaneously parity broken symmetry. The other experiment corresponds to periodic systems. So if in place of, let's forget now about polarization and consider different centers, then we can consider, for example, chain of centers, and we can reproduce the weak lasing solution when we start from ideal chain, and but due to this bifurcation to weak lasing state, we have AB with different occupation of A and B. And it is possible to study the stability of this state, and this is some generalization for two-dimensional superlattices. Again, we have here square lattice with different occupation of nearest neighbors. And this is how it should emit light in the reciprocal space. That would be emission if we have just condensation in the edge of Brillouin zone with pi difference. So if you just have pi difference between centers, equal occupation, you would have something like that. Weak lasing corresponds to appearance of, apart from these peaks and edges of the old Brillouin zone, we have peak and k equal to zero. Also, it is possible to consider honeycomb, and again, here we can appreciate that the symmetry k to minus k is broken. And this formation of this weak lasing state was recently observed in one-dimensional superlattices, not exactly in semiconductor microcavity, but in zinc O micro road, which is put on top of silicon substrate with some periodic grating, and in this state, indeed, it was observed the formation of light emitted with the same frequency, but composed with peaks at the edges of Brillouin zone and central k equal to zero peak. Fortunately, the experiment is slightly distorted by disorder. So probably I will skip all this. And I will conclude. So weak lasing is effect which corresponds to formation of spontaneous symmetry breaking, the formation of states near the threshold, which corresponds to spontaneous symmetry breaking in the system, and they are essentially many particle states. And recently, this effect of weak lasing was observed both in polarization state of single condensate and in superlattice of polariton superlattice. And I should acknowledge the collaboration with Igor Alerin and Boris Altshuler. We did the first work about theory of this weak lasing effect. Then I acknowledge Sergei Flach and Christian Rayanov. We collaborated on the study of this frequency combo emission and formation of limit circles. There is ongoing collaboration with Alexei Kavokin, Sasha Podumny, Southampton, St. Petersburg, Tim Liu from Singapore, and experimental group Jeremy Baumberg from Cambridge, and Shanghai Chen from China. And that's about what I wanted to say about condensation of exciton polaritons. And now I would like to say a few words about condensation of people. So to have condensation of people, it is necessary to have some outstanding human being, some outstanding man. And I first met Boris here in this very center. It was in 93. It was, and I had the privilege to, and I was listening to his wonderful lectures on conductance fluctuations, and it was easy to see the condensation the people around Boris, because you could identify Boris very easily, either here or in corridors on the seaside. There is always a cloud of people around him trying to convince him on something or arguing something. And when you create, I understand it is a great responsibility when you create such a condensate of people. And Boris told me that his first name comes from old synagogue in Prague. And there is a legend, folkloric, related to this synagogue. It's about golem. So when rabbi created a clay person and then put a life in it, and this golem was actually a good guy. It was a soldier. It protected community. However, there are some various different variations of this legend. For example, there is clay boy, which was a bad guy, which just grows, and it was catastrophic consequences. I particularly like the variation when rabbi created a clay cow, and then by sorcery put a life in it, and all the community fit on this cow. So I believe the condensate created by Boris is wonderful, because we all feed on Boris, on his ideas, on his knowledge, on his wisdom, as this conference demonstrates. So Boris, many happy renters, and increase and proliferate your condensate of people. Thank you.